بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم آئی ایم ڈاکٹر محمد عدنان ورکنگ ایز اسسٹنٹ پروفیسر ان دا ڈپارٹمنٹ آف فزکس کوہاٹ یونیورسٹی آف سائنس اینڈ ٹیکنالوجی آئی ویلکم یو ٹو دی کورس پی ایچ وائی 482 لیزر پلازما انٹریکشن اٹ از دی 7th لیکچر آف دس کورس اینڈ ویل بی ٹاکنگ اباؤٹ دی ویو ایکویشن فار لائٹ ویوز ان پلازما. First, I will give the learning objective. At the end of this lecture, the student will understand how a plasma modifies the propagation of electromagnetic waves. We know that the electromagnetic wave propagation are characterized by omega is equal to ck, that is, electromagnetic waves are constant velocity waves once we are talking about vacuum. But when once plasma is there, so the propagation characteristics of the electromagnetic wave changes, and in this lecture we will see how the wave propagation changes once plasma is there. In this course we are following the book The Physics of Laser Plasma Interaction by William L. Cruell. In this lecture, I have taken some of the illustrations from this book. Okay, if we assume that there are no large imposed or self-generated magnetic field, so that we'll begin with the linearized plasma response to a high frequency field of the form E is equal to Ex e to the power minus iota omega t. Now this omega is the frequency of the light waves, or we can say the electromagnetic waves, those are incident on the plasma. Of course, this omega has to be greater than the plasma frequency omega p in order to have penetration inside the plasma. We will see more detail on this omega and the critical density and all those things in this lecture. Now, under the high frequency assumption, we can say that the ions are, in another word, we can say this omega is greater than the omega PE, or the electron plasma frequency. So in this regard, we can say that the ions are to be treated as stationary, neutralizing the background with a constant density and not I. Now, in order to describe these waves, we'll start with the equation of motion. And here, from the previous course, you learned that we have ignored the convective term since we are not interested in the nonlinear aspect at the moment. And also, as I told you, if we assume that no large imposed or self-generated magnetic field is there, so that V cross B is not there, so the equation of motion contains only the electric field, and that profile is given by the first equation. So in the equation of motion, we have utilized the profile of the electromagnetic wave with the frequency omega. Now the current density is defined as N naught EV, so that if we take the derivative of this J with respect to time, so that we'll be getting dJ over dt, and we'll be having, since this is constant in time and this E is the electronic charge, so we'll be left with curly E over curly t, and that is given here in the equation of motion. So if we used in this rate of change of the current density from the equation of motion, so that we'll be getting this term, where this omega PE is the electron plasma frequency given by this expression, where N naught is the electron density. Hence, we can say that the current density can be expressed in terms of the electric field, where this high frequency conductivity of plasma is given by this expression. These are the routine equation that you have learned in the first course on the plasma physics. But first we looked how we derive the dispersion relation, or we can say the equation, wave equation for the electromagnetic waves in plasma. So that we are doing here. Now, to develop the wave equation for the oscillating electric and magnetic field, we consider the Faraday law and Ampere's law. So this is the Faraday law. Curl of E is curl B over curl T. So that can be expressed by minus iota omega. And also, curl of B is mu naught J. And plus, we can say the rate of change of the electric field. So that if we take from these two terms E common, so that we'll be left with this iota omega over C, and this epsilon is nothing but the dielectric function of the plasma, defined as 1 minus omega P square over omega square. So if we take the curl of this first equation and using this curl of B over here that you have done in the previous course as well, so that curl of E will give rise to this term, using the Beck-Cabe rule, we'll be left with this well-known equation which you have derived many times in the plasma physics course. Now, in the same way, we can develop this equation, which is a more or less a general equation. You will see that today we'll be talking about the light waves, or we can say the electromagnetic waves in plasma having constant density. So we'll be solving this for constant density today, and we'll be left with the equations, or we can say the dispersion relation for the light waves once there are density gradients in the plasma. So this is the general equation. We'll be using this in the coming few lectures as well. So in the similar way, we can derive equation for the magnetic field as well by taking curl of this equation and utilizing the above equation. So that curl of B is given by this, and since taking curl of this term will give rise to these two terms, and that will give us an equation that we have obtained for the electric field. So if we bring that equation just for the comparison, so the first step to analyze how the equation, or we can say the wave equation, or people call it a dispersion relation for the electromagnetic waves in plasma, changes. So we'll start with these two equations. One is for the electric field that we have derived on the previous slide, and this one is for the magnetic field. As I told you, today we'll be talking about the dispersion relation, or the wave equation, for the electromagnetic wave in a plasma with uniform density. So if you take that uniform density approximation, so that this gradient of epsilon is equal to zero, that is the gradient, there are no gradient in the density profile, so that the plasma dielectric function is uniform. And since we are talking about electromagnetic waves, so electromagnetic waves are transverse waves, so that the wave vector is perpendicular, or we can say the wave propagation direction is perpendicular to the electric field and also the magnetic field. So this k dot E will be zero, so that based on these two assumptions, the two equations will be identical, such that this term will be zero and this term will be zero, so that we'll be having an identical equation for the two situations. So using the Fourier decomposition, we'll be having a dispersion relation in the form of omega square over c square times epsilon equal to k square. And if we use the definition of this epsilon, which is 1 minus omega p square over omega square, so that we'll be having the standard dispersion relation, which we have discussed in the previous course as well, that is omega square, which is the frequency of the electromagnetic waves, or we can say the light waves, and this omega p square is the plasma frequency, and then k square and the c square is the velocity of light. Where this omega p square is by definition equal to this, that is, it depends upon the density, and as I told you, we are talking about the uniform density profile for today, so that this omega p square, which is part of this epsilon as well, so that this epsilon is uniform once we are talking about gradient of E equal to zero. If you remember, we have plotted this expression as well, such that if we are talking about the light waves or electromagnetic waves in vacuum, so that this naught, n naught, will be equal to zero, and then this omega p square will not be there, so that omega square is equal to zero plus c square k square, that is, omega is equal to c k, and that will be just a straight line having constant slope, that is, slope is c, that is, the electromagnetic waves or the light waves in vacuum are constant velocity waves, but once plasma are there, so that the dispersion is there because of the presence of the plasma. So it modifies the wave propagations of the electromagnetic waves. And as I told you, this situation is for the uniform density profile. So first we'll see some of the aspect of this expression before we leave the solution, or we can say the solution of these two equation for the non-uniform, or we can say having density gradients, so that we'll be switching to WKB solution for the wave propagation for the next class. So before going to the WKB solution for the two expression that I told you, once we are talking about the wave equation for electromagnetic waves, these are the starting point. I have shown today how one can obtain these two equation, but we'll start with this expression. So this omega square is equal to omega p square plus k square c square is the dispersion relation for the light waves in plasma. Now note that the omega p is the minimum frequency for propagation of the light waves in a plasma, and this k becomes imaginary, as we have discussed in the previous course. And at the beginning I told you that once omega is smaller than omega p, then this k becomes imaginary, and the medium becomes opaque for the electromagnetic waves. So this omega has to be greater than the plasma frequency in order to have the propagation of electromagnetic waves in plasma, or we can say the medium. So since the characteristic response time for the electron is this thing, since this the plasma, this is dimensions of frequency, so frequency inverse will be having the time. So that this is the characteristic response time for the electron. So the electron shield out the field of the light waves, or we can say the electromagnetic waves, when the frequency of the electromagnetic wave is smaller than omega p square. So it has to be greater than omega p square in order to have wave propagation through the medium. Hence the condition that omega is equal to omega p defines the maximum plasma density to which light waves can penetrate, and that can be expressed in terms of this critical density, which is 1.1 10 to the power 21 over lambda mu square, and that is expressed in terms of 1 mu m equal to 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter in units. So that is the situations once we have uniform density profile, and the light wave changes from omega square is equal to c square k square to omega square is equal to omega p square plus c square k square. That is, the waves are now dispersive, and it depends upon the propagation, depends upon the frequency of the electromagnetic waves, and also it is linked with the density of the plasma through which the electromagnetic waves propagate. Now, as I told you, to investigate some of the basic features of the propagation of light waves in an inhomogeneous plasma, let's consider a plane wave normally incident onto a plasma slab, and assuming that the variation in the density is along the z direction, so that the same features are now changed. That is, the density is now z dependent. That is, the density is changing along the z axis, so that the plasma dielectric function is now a function of omega, and also it depends upon the z coordinate as well. And if you see, the profile of the electric field is now, the amplitude is z dependent, having the omega, which is the frequency of the electromagnetic wave. So up till now we have discussed the wave equation for the light waves in plasma, having n naught, which is constant, but once there are variation in the density, once we are moving along the z coordinate, so that means we are talking about inhomogeneous plasma now. So these features are now changed, so that the two equations, as I told you, for the electric field and magnetic field that we have developed through the equation of motion and also from the Maxwell's equation, will now take a new form other than that identical form, under the assumption that del dot E equal to zero, and also the gradient of the dielectric function is equal to zero for the homogeneous plasma case. So now these two equations, under these assumptions, in the Cartesian coordinate will take this form, so that this is the profile of the electric field, and likewise for the magnetic field. So in order to investigate the basic features of the propagation of the light waves in plasma, having inhomogeneous density profile, so that these two equations will take these forms. Now, as I told you, we will be doing this thing in the next class. That is, first we'll develop the WKB solution for the fields. That is, we'll be solving these two set of equations for WKB approximation. Although we know that this this WKB solution is limited to weak density gradients, this solution provides an excellent illustration of how gradients in the densities, as I told you, we are talking about inhomogeneous plasma, affect the wave propagation. Once we obtain the approximate solution for the inhomogeneous plasma for the wave equation, once we are talking about the light waves, then we will complement this analysis with the exact solution for the field, assuming a linear variation in the plasma density. So in the coming lecture, we'll be going through the WKB solution for the wave equation of the electromagnetic waves in plasma, having inhomogeneous plasma. But you need to go through this small assignment, which is, as I told you, for the homogeneous plasma case, homogeneous density plasma case, we obtain this omega square is equal to omega p square plus c square k square. Then you need to show that how the wave propagations, the wave vector k becomes imaginary once we are talking about the electromagnetic waves having frequency smaller than the plasma frequency, so that k becomes imaginary, and the the wave will not propagate through the plasma. So you need to just show this through a few steps. That is, you need to obtain the value of K from this expression under this condition, so that K becomes imaginary, and you need to verify that under this condition the wave will not propagate through the plasma. And with this, I thank you for your time.